Welcome to Geeks 4x4, the most budget-oriented 4x4 channel in all the YouTubes. And today, we are going to do a rig walk-around of the ZJ. And this camera, I always can't figure out which way to point. So let's get it going to the ZJ here. It's a 95 Grand Cherokee ZJ, limited. It had 94,000 miles on it when we bought it. Was a real cream puff, probably been garage-kept its whole life. Let's get walking around and I'll start telling you guys about it. Alright, I figure we'll start right up front here. And as you can tell, we have a stock front bumper, but we have got different lights. These are the Z-Moon LED lights, and those I've done a review on. I'm going to put the link up in there for those. Those lights are still holding up great, and they're super bright. And then, right down in here is when the good stuff starts. So, Kevin's Off-Road, I believe, makes this front radiator support stiffener for the ZJ with the shackle mounts, and I ended up cutting. You can see where I cut to put that on. I cut this bar, the farthest bar, out of the front bumper, and then I put a self-tapper right in the middle, and that's held up just fine to hold it in. So this is the front frame stiffener from Kevin's Off-Road, and for radiator support. You got Alien Off-Road diff covers down here, stock Dana 30 axle in the front, stock steering. It's got Iron Rock springs, so IRO Off-Road, I think they're 4.5-inch springs. And Zone, I just put those Zone quick release sway bar links because the Rough Country ones were destroyed. After like 10,000 miles, they made all kinds of noise. And I was very disappointed with the Rough Country one. So, that is the front here. Brakes are stock, has 1.25-inch wheel spacers to run these 98 limited wheels. This had the spoke wheels on it, the 15. We wanted to go with the 16, and we put some General Grabber X3s on them. Love this tire, and they've been holding up really well. These tires are 265, 75, 16s. So they're like a 32. So right in the wheel well, you can see the quick release sway bar, and you can see one other thing that I forgotten about that I did. When you lift these, there was something to do with the sway bar bracket in the front, the bushings and stuff. And so I had to replace those. I'll put a link down below to those. I think those are just Amazon special sway bar bracket holders. They're greasable and they're working great.
So those sway bar bushing holders are needed when you put that Kevin's Off-Road front radiator support. That eliminates the stock ones. They don't mount back up there, and you have to put those in. I also didn't mention that this has an Iron Rock Off-Road double shear track bar. You can see that mount right here in the wheel well.
Bilstein shocks and extended brake lines. There's those IRO springs. And I actually did not move the bump stops from factory. The bump stops are factory. And this will tuck the tire all the way up. There's a link to this thing flexing out. I'll put it up there again. And this will tuck these tires in this fender. And then I trimmed the bumper. You can see it would have had this edge all the way down. And I trimmed the bumper just enough, and you can actually turn while it's full flexed. It doesn't hit back here. So, Kevin's Off-Road again, rock sliders. These are massively beefy, and they're pretty sweet. And then the good stuff. So, you can see in here, we got long arm. So this is the Rough Country long arm for a ZJ that comes with this belly pan, the front half of it. So this I actually made out of a skid plate from Iron Rock, I believe, for the ZJ. And then this was the skid plate that came with the Rough Country. We welded them together so that I got a good transfer case skid. So that is a 242 transfer case. So it has the full-time and part-time four-wheel drive. Also has a true two-wheel drive, a true neutral, and a true four low. So, custom drive shafts from Inland Valley Driveline in California.
So, as I am editing this, I am realizing that I didn't talk about the drive shafts and the transfer case enough. This does have a slip yoke eliminator on it. That transfer case is a 242. It actually has a 249 gear in the front of it. But yeah, it does have a slip yoke eliminator, and the transfer case is custom for a ZJ like you guys would see. There is also a Novak shifter cable to make the transfer case easy to shift.
See the long arm up front as well, doing its thing. Out back, we've got Bilstein shocks again, another extended brake line. I don't remember exactly, I think those might be Kevin's. They were ordered with the kit. And then a IRO, I believe, gas tank skid for this gas tank, stock gas tank. It's 20 gallons or so. And then another Alien off-road. I found those at all J Jeep products and Big Bear, and I had to pull the diffs apart anyway to check them, so I put those on. So back here, we are looking at a factory bumper, but I mounted this because down in Sand Hollow where I'm playing, and any sand dunes, you want a whip, and I like to have a quick release mount on the whip. So this is actually bolted through the metal behind the bumper. I can see it spider cracking the bumper, but not super worried about that. We also put these little LEDs in for reverse lights. Those are just super nice to have because they light it up when you're out at night. So that is pretty much the outside of it, if I can remember right. This is a very stock-looking-ish, kind of. I don't know. Whatever you guys think. But I think it looks pretty stock. But it's very capable, very flexible. More flexible than my LJ. On the interior, this is from Mountain Vista Fabrication. It mounts to the A-pillars. Get a better view of it right there. And gives you a really nice handle. Those original handles that are now 25 plus years old on these ZJs, they break when you put any weight on them, doesn't matter. So for radio mounts, I've got my CB right up there, and then I have the race radio down there. So they both have magnet mounts. There's one, and the other one is back in here for the antennas. Just Jeep mats. Other than that, this interior is still original. This Jeep only has, I can show you, 109,000 miles on it. So it's in really good shape for what it is. Even though it has that low of miles, it's gonna need seats soon because they're not holding up that well to actually driving it. So in the back, I have got I didn't even say the tire size. A 265 75 16, so a 32 inside the back of the Jeep. I put extenders, if you can see in the camera there. So that's the original J hook that goes into the mount, and then I just grabbed threaded extenders and extended this out so that I can mount this tire in here. It doesn't fit amazingly, but it does fit, and it does work. So under the hood, you're looking very stock, at a very stock 5.2 with an auto behind it, obviously, because they only did the manual and it's in a straight six. This motor's been pretty good. It definitely needed a lot of work from all the sitting that it did when we first bought it. It got water pump and AC fully rebuilt, which the mode door's not working anymore, so it doesn't work. But other than that, it's pretty straightforward. The other issue I've had is if you're keen on eyes, you can see that this isn't quite hooked up. So the ZJs have a computer-controlled voltage regulator. And something in the computer goes, and they stop controlling voltage. So this got a new alternator and a new battery one trip, and come to find out that it just needed an external voltage regulator. So you can see that's from a Dodge truck. There's a write-up. If you're interested in that, you can let me know, and I'll get you the link to that write-up. But pretty much external voltage regulator on this. Other than that, this motor, 5.2, completely stock, 109,000 miles. So there it is. There's a walk around of a pretty built Jeep ZJ that might not look like it from the outside, but crawling underneath it, it's got a lot of goodies on it. It's super capable. This one's pretty special to me. My dad bought it and bought all the parts, and then unfortunately got sick and passed away. And this Jeep was his brainchild and his, his dream. So I got to build it and see those come true. So yeah, I think this Jeep is pretty cool. It's super capable. It'll do 3 and 4 trails all day long and do them with pretty much ease. Like I said, it's the highest flexing Jeep that I own. The LJ doesn't flex as much as this thing. But I really like it. You can drive down the highway in it, 70 miles an hour, no problem. And you can also go get the groceries and blend in a little bit. But you can also take it out in the middle of nowhere and go do whatever you need to do with it. So anyway, thank you for watching. This Jeep, I always ask everybody else, and I realize I didn't give you guys a price on my LJ. So I'm going to give you kind of a price here. This has about, if I remember right, we paid $2,500 for the Jeep, which is typical ZJ. Look, they're out there. There's some good low miles ones out there for cheap. And then we probably have $7,000 or $8,000 in parts. So this is about a $10,000 build, and it's super capable and ready to go hit the trails, ready to go do whatever you want to do with it. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share. We will see you next time. I might be skipping a week here. I'm going on vacation next week. So just so you guys know, might not have a video out next week, but the week after we'll be right back on our regularly scheduled program. We'll see you then.